Hey guys, in this video we are going to create an amazing and beautiful looking website with just HTML and CSS. So without wasting any time, let's get started. So this is the demo of our website where we have a beautiful looking navigation menu. We have a beautiful looking call to action button, and in the hero section we have two containers. First one is this text container where we have a heading, paragraph, and this amazing button which have a beautiful design. And on the right side we have a illustration with a beautiful background. So let's move to the second part, and in the second part we have this beautiful looking why us section in which we have a heading and a beautiful paragraph. So the third part is quite amazing and beautiful. Here we have a feature section, and in the feature section we have four feature items in which we have a icon, heading, and a description which describes the features of our website. So let's move to the next part. The next part is beautiful and amazing design of our blog section, where we have a simple heading which is looking amazing, and we have a blog section where we have four articles. We have image of article, the author name, then the heading, and then the description of the articles. So the last part of our build is this beautiful looking footer section where we have social container, social icons, menu item, and this call to action button. So let's get started and go to our code editor. I'm using Visual Studio Code. You can use any of the code editor that you want, such as Sublime Text, Brackets, and many more that you want. So if you haven't subscribed to this channel, you should subscribe to this channel, because I upload daily project videos about front-end development on this channel. So you will get a lot of knowledge and you will get a lot of value from this channel, which help you to improve your front-end skills. So let's get started. First of all, I will create a boilerplate for my HTML file. I will change the title into Easy Bank. First of all, I will import my style.css. Now save it. So as you see in the demo, we have a logo, then we have a navigation menu, and then we have a beautiful looking button. So first of all, let's create a navbar. This is a nav. I will give it a class of navbar. In the navbar we have a logo which will be image dot slash. I will go to the images folder. So I will give all of the code and in the description of this video. I will upload all of the files and code into my GitHub repository, and you will get all of the files that I have used, the images and the code, by clicking in the description of this video and download it from my GitHub repository. So you can follow this tutorial and you can build this project by your own. So let's get started. First of all, we have our logo. Then we have a container which will say nav items. In the nav items we have, let's see, we have home, about, contact, home. Let's copy this and repeat it three more times. 1, 2, 3, home. The second one is about. The third one is contact, and the other one are blog and carriers. So this one will be blog, and the last one will be carriers. So let's save it, and under this div of nav items we want a button with a class of, with a text of request invite. So the text will be request invite. Let's save it and open it with the live server. Now you will see a very ugly design. As you see, it's not looking good, and we also have a default margin. So first of all, we will go to our style.css file, and here I will remove the default margin, set it to 0, padding will be 0, box sizing will be a border box. Now let's target the body. I will set the font family to this one. Let's save this, and now you will see a significant change. Now we have to target our navbar. So in the navbar, I will use display flex. Display flex. Justify content will be a space around, and align items will be a center. Give a padding top of 20 pixel, padding bottom of 20 pixel. Let's see how to look. Now these have aligned in the right direction. We just want to style these. First of all, I will target the nav items. So nav items, I will target the A tag. I will remove the text decoration and set it to none, because we don't want a default style of links. So text decoration will be none. Font size will be 1.25, so 1.2 rem. Let's see how it will look. Now it's looking good. So let's copy the color. I think we will use this grayish blue color, so as the color of our nav items. So let's set this color. Now you will see it's looking good, but we just have to increase the font weight to 600. Now you see it's looking good. So give them a margin left of 10 pixel. Now they have a beautiful design and it's looking quite eye-catching. So let's move to the next part. And now target the button in the nav bar and increase the padding from top and bottom 12 pixel, from left and right 28 pixel. Let's see how it will look. Now it's not looking quite great, because we have a nav bar, and in this nav bar we have a button, and now I think it will work. Now it's looking good. Let's see. So I think let's set the border to none. Outline width will be 0. So color will be a white. We want a linear gradient color as a background color. So for this, we have to use a background image property for our button and set it to linear gradient. It will be 120 degree, and the colors are this green and the bright cyan color. So I will copy the color, paste it here, and the other one will be this bright cyan color. So let's copy this color, paste it here. Now let's save. Hope it will look good. Now it's looking good. We just want to change the colors. First of all, we have to use a blue color, and then we will use a green color. Now let's save. Hope it will look good. Now it's looking beautiful. Just give it a border radius of 24 pixel. Cursor will be pointer. So the cursor will be pointer. And now you will see we have a beautiful design of our button. We can also increase the font weight for our button. Let's give it a font weight of 400. Now it's looking amazing. So the first part of our build is completed, which is this navigation menu. So let's move to the second part. So for second part, we have to go to our index.html file. And here we have two containers. First one will be a text container, and the second one will be an image container. So under the navbar, we will create a header and give it the class name of hero. Hero-section. So first container will be a hero dash text container. And the second container will be a hero-image container. So in the hero text container we have a heading, we have a paragraph and a button. So the text for, I will copy the text for our heading. You can pause the video and copy the text. So the text will be this one. The br tag is basically for a line break. So for paragraph, I will copy the text. Control C, Control V. And the button for text for button will be same, which will be a request invite that we have used for our navigation menu button. So let's save this one. The image on the right side will be ./images folder. We have mockup. Let's see how it's looking. Now you'll see it's not looking great. We just want to target our hero section. Give it a, I think so, set it to display flex. Justify content will be space around. Align items will be a center. Let's see. Now you will see it's not looking good because we have to target our hero dash image section and reduce the size of the image because the image size is quite greater. Set the width of to 500 pixel. Hero image, let's see what is the class name. Hero image container, it's not section. Let's copy this class name and replace with this. So we have to remove one H. Let's save this one and I think it will look good. Let's refresh the page. So it's not working right now because we have a spelling mistake, and now it will work. So we have to give a background in the hero image container. We give it a background image of, first of all I will go into the images folder and give it a background image of this. So now we have a background image. We just want to set it by giving it background image properties, such as background size will be a cover, background position will be a center, background repeat will be no repeat. Let's save. Now it's looking good. So instead of center, let's try bottom. Let's see what will affect. Now it's looking good and amazing. So just give it a padding top of 20 pixel. Let's see if it affect or not. Now you'll see it's looking good. So give it a height to our hero section. So the height for our hero section will be 90 viewport height, and now it's looking beautiful. So let's target the hero text section. So hero text, not hero text section, it's a container. So I will target it in our CSS file dot this one, set it to display flex. Flex direction will be a column, justify content will be a space between, and align items will be a flex start. So let's save this one, and in the hero text container we'll target the h1, then we will target the paragraph in the hero text container. Now we'll target the paragraph, and then we will target the button. So for h1 we will give it a font size of, let's give it a 60 pixel, font weight of 800, margin bottom of 15 pixel, and the color will be the dark blue color. So this color I will use for our heading, and set the color to this one. Let's save it. Let's see how to look. So we just want to set a line height to 1.1. let's see how to look. Now it's looking beautiful. So let's try 70 pixel maybe. Now we have a beautiful looking title. We have given it a margin bottom of 15 pixel. Let's set it to 20 pixel. You can test different values. So 20 pixel is looking good. Now for paragraph, I will set the color to grayish blue, which will be this one. So let's copy this color and paste it in the colors of paragraph. So what we have to do is give it a margin bottom of 15 pixel. Let's save it. Now increase the font weight to 700, and now you will see it's looking good right now, as we have in the demo. So in the button I will give it the same values that we have given to our navbar button. So let's copy this text and paste in the hero section navbar. In the button of hero section. So let's see. Now you will see we have a beautiful looking hero section, in which we have a excellent and an eye-catching heading, paragraph, and this call to action button. And on the right side we have a beautiful looking illustration with the eye-catching and beautiful background image. So let's move to the second part of the build. So in the second part, as you will see, we have a background color of gray, and in the gray color we have three containers: YS container, feature section, and this block section. So first of all I will create a container and wrap all of these three section in this container. So under the header section we have a container, and in this container we will create our next section, which will be Y. So in this section we have heading and a paragraph. Why choose EasyBank? So the heading will be Why choose EasyBank? Question mark. Oops. So the paragraph will be, I will copy the paragraph. You can pause the video and copy this paragraph. It's a simple paragraph which describes about our website. So let's move to the next line, paste it here, save it, and let's go to our CSS file. And here we will have a container, and in the container we will set the background color to the grayish blue color, which will be this one, I think. So grayish blue or light grayish blue. So let's try this light grayish blue. You can try different. So let's give it a height of 30 viewport height, just to see the color. So here we will have a color under the hero section. Now it's looking good. The same, this is the color that we want. So now remove the heading, not heading, height. So let's target the YS section. I will copy the class name for our YS section. Control C. So let's do this. Give it a margin, not a margin top. So let's give it a padding top of 10 viewport height. You can also use pixels and RAM units, also M units. I'm keeping it a simple, so that's why I'm using a viewport height. So the padding top will be 10 pixel. I will set the width to 80%, and I will use margin left auto and margin right of auto to keep it in this, in the middle. So we have got it in the middle. Just give it a margin bottom, or maybe padding bottom of 10 viewport height to this container. So now you will see we have a heading and a paragraph. So in the YS section, I will target the heading first of all, and then I will target the paragraph. Oops. So for heading, I will copy the properties for the heading of the hero section. We just want to remove some of these values, such as we want to decrease the font size to, let's try 30 pixel, and line, we will remove the line height. Let's save this one, and now you see it's looking good. Just increase the font size to 50 pixel. Now the 50 pixel is looking great. I think let's use a 45 pixel. Now the 45 pixel is looking beautiful and amazing. Let's copy these properties of the class name that we have used. So I will copy the properties for class name of paragraph. Let's save it here. Let's see how it will look. Now it's looking amazing. So we have a YS section completed. Now the third part is this feature section, in which we have feature items. Let's move to our index.html file. Under this section and in a container, I will create a new section with the class name of features-section, where we have a feature-item in which we will have an image. So the first one will be, let's see, it will be online banking. So its image will be something like banking online. Oops. This one will be, and this, then we have a heading and a paragraph. I will copy the text for heading and a paragraph. So online banking, let's copy and paste it here. Now we'll also copy the paragraph text. Let's copy and paste it here. Now you will see in the demo website we have a four of these items. So what I will do, I will copy this feature item, which will be this one, and repeat it three more times. 1, 2, 3. So I think we have completed 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's save this one. And now you will see it has aligned in the vertical direction, but we want it in the horizontal direction. Let's copy the class name for feature section. So copy the class name for feature section, go to style.css, and here we will target the feature section. Set the width to 80%. Set the margin left of auto and margin right of auto to keep it in the middle or in the same alignment as you will see. So what we will use, display flex, justify content space between, align items flex dot, let's save it. And now you will see with this two or three lines of code we have completely changed the design. So in the feature section we have a feature first. So let's copy the class name for feature item. So this will be the class name. And now, oops, we have to write a dot first of all. And now in the feature we'll target the image and set the width to 80 pixel. Let's see, 80 pixel is too much. Let's try 65 pixel. Now it's looking good. So we want to give a margin bottom to our features, so it will be padding bottom of 10 viewport height. Now you will see we have a padding below. Now let's target the feature item h1 tag, and then we will target the feature item paragraph tag. We will use the same of these properties. So let's copy the heading values, paste it here. So what we want is, let's save it. And now you will see it's not looking good. Just decrease the heading to 25 pixel. And give a margin bottom of 10 pixel to our image, which is the icon. Now it's looking good. So let's now copy the properties of the paragraph also. So what we have to do, I think so, let's try 10 pixel margin bottom and remove it from here. Let's see. Now you'll see it's looking beautiful and is completely eye-catching design. So just have a look what we have built. This design is simply amazing and beautiful. So let's move to our index.html file and change the content for our other files. So I will copy the second heading. So the second heading will be simple budgeting. So let's use simple budgeting as the second heading, and the paragraph will be this one. You can pause the video and copy this paragraph. So let's change the icon to online, oops, budgeting. The third heading will be, let's say it is a fast onboarding. So let's copy this one and replace the heading. And now copy this paragraph, replace this paragraph. and also change the icon. So the icon we want is onboarding. So I will change the icon. So the icon will be onboarding. Let's change the heading of the fourth feature item. So heading for the fourth feature item will be Open API. We have also copied a tag, which is not a good thing to do. Control V. And the paragraph for this section is going to be this one. So pause the video and copy this paragraph. Let's change the icon and set it to, I think, AP, this one. Now go to our website, and now you will see we have a different icons, different heading and a different paragraph, and all in all it's looking good. So just decrease the margin bottom of our icon. Let's go to the CSS file, and margin bottom will be 5 pixels. Let's see, now it's looking good and beautiful. So the next part of our build is this beautiful looking blog section, where we have a beautiful design of blogs. So let's go to our index.html file and create a section. So we will create a new section, which will be a it will be a blog dash section. So don't do a spelling mistake. So first of all, we have a heading. The heading will say latest articles, and under the heading we will have a container which will wrap all of the articles. So we will say it as article dash container. So first of all, we have a, in the article container we have articles. So I gave it a name of article. Here we will have an image. Then we will have a, so first of all, the first image will be money image. So I will go to the images folder. Let's get a money. Oops. Let's see, where is it? So currency image. And under the image we have a author name, we have a heading, and then we have this description. So what I will do, I will wrap it in a article container. So we have a div which will say what I think. I give it a class name of content. Give it a class name of content. We have a paragraph where we have author name. Then we have a heading which will be h4, and we have a heading. So I will copy the heading. So the heading will be receive money in any currency with no fees. So let's paste this heading. Then we have a description which will be a paragraph. So copy this paragraph, pause the video and copy this paragraph. Now let's move to, so let's go to our website. Now you'll see we have the image size is not looking good. So let's go to our file index.html, and we will copy the article. I think so it will be from this. So copy this and repeat it four more times. Three more times. Two, three. Let's save this one. And now you will see we have a quite ugly design. We just want to make it similar to this. So let's go to our CSS file by copying the block section class name. So first of all, Control C, we'll go to our file style sheet and target this, set the width to 80%. We'll use the same technique, margin left auto, margin right auto, to bring it in the middle. So here you see. So what we will do is set the display to flex. Flex direction will be a column. Justify content will be a center. And align items will be a flex. Start. Let's see how it will look. Not looking good. We just want to target the article container. Let's target the article container and set it to display flex, justify content space between, and align items will be a flex dot. Now you will see it break our website because the image size is too much. So in the article, let's copy the article. We have an image. Let's set the height and width of this image. So in the article we have an image, set the width to 250 pixels and height will be 250. Oops, we have to give it a height of 250. Let's save it. And now you see we have an image. So for our article container, or we can say blog section, give it a margin bottom, or we can say padding bottom of 10 viewport height. You can use RAM, M units, and also pixels. Let's save it and go to our website. And now you will see we have decreased the size of these images. So I think we have to target the article, give it a margin left of 10 pixels. Let's see how it will affect. Now we have a bit, it's not looking good right now. What we'll use a 1.25 RAM. We'll give it a margin top of, let's give it a margin top of I think 1.5 RAM. Let's see. Now it's looking good. We just want to give a background color to our containers. So what we will do is to, first of all, in the article container we have a heading, and we will give the same properties that we have used for our heading earlier. So copy this and paste it here. Let's see how it will look. Oops, it's not targeting because article container, not in the article container, it's in the blog section. So target the blog section. Let's save it, and now you'll see a change. Let's increase the font size to 45 pixels maybe. Now it's looking good. Give it a margin left of 1.25 frame. Let's save it. And now you'll see it's as aligned in the same direction. So what we will do is we should give a background color to our article. So let's give it a background color of white. Let's see how it will look. Now you'll see we have a background for our article. It's not so viewable. So as we increase, as I'm zooming, so you will see a background color. So let's reduce the size, and now we'll target in the article. We have a container with the name of content. So let's paste it here. And what we'll do is to first of all we'll target the p tag. Oops. And in the p tag we use the same properties that we have used earlier. We don't want some new properties. Let's try the older ones. Let's see how it will look. Now you'll see it's not looking great because the font weight, it is too much. Let's remove the font weight. And now you'll see it's looking good. We just want a padding. So give it a font weight of 400. Let's see how it will affect. Now it's looking good. So what we will do is to give, we will give it a padding. Oops, what happened? Padding will be 15 pixel. I think 15 pixel of padding will look good. So it is affecting our image. So let's give a height to our container. Width will be 250 pixel and height will be, I think so, let's try height of max content. Let's see how it will look. Now we have the height. Just to reduce the font size, let's set the font size to 10 pixel. I think it will look good. No, the 10 pixel is too low. Let's try 14 pixel. Now the 14 pixel is looking good. Just increase it to 16 pixel. Let's see how it will look. Now the 16 pixel is breaking our code. Not 14. Sorry, not 15, 14. 14 is looking good. So, oops. What happened? So what we have to do is to not a max content, we give it a fixed height so we don't break our website. I think give it a height of 300 pixel. Let's see. Now the save it. So give it to margin bottom to our blog section, padding bottom, just give it a margin bottom of 20 viewport height. We will remove it later. Just give it so we have a space. So as you see we are breaking it. So what we will do in the article, I think so, where is our article? Here. So increase the height to 500 pixel maybe. Now just, so we'll just reduce it to 400 pixel. Let's see Which one will look good? Oops. So the one thing we have to do is we remove the background color from article and give the background color to content only, because we don't want a background color for the images. So oops, we are breaking our app. Let's see what's happening here. So we just have to, I think I will go to the demo of the website and I will see what's happening. So in the style sheet we are breaking something. So let's see. So here we have an article content, and for our article we have height to max content. Let's give these properties to our article. Let's see how it will affect it. Let's save. Oops, our app is something broken because we have removed the curly brace. We don't want to remove this one. So let's save this one. And now you will see we have a beautiful looking card. We just want to give it a padding. So the padding will be, I think so, for article. Where is our content? Remove the background. Let's save this one. We just give it a padding of, I think 15 pixel will be enough. Yeah, the 15 pixel is looking good. We just have to, so what's happening? I think in our content we have a p tag, we have h4 tag, so our style is not working. In the content we have to target the h4 tag. Content, we will target the h4, give it some of the properties such as color of the same color that we have used for our heading earlier. So the same color, let's copy this color and paste it here. Let's save it. And now we have a good beautiful looking color. So what we'll do is to, for content we don't want a padding for just P. That's why our card is looking ugly. We want a padding for our content. So this is the bug that's breaking our app. So give it a padding of 15 pixel. Now you see it's looking beautiful right now. So we have found the bug that's breaking our app. So in programming and web development you will find a lot of situations where you will get stuck for a simple mistake. So this is the mistake, because we want to give a padding to our content but we gave it to the paragraph. So this was the mistake. And now what we'll do, in the we'll give it a padding bottom. Oops, we'll give a padding bottom to paragraph, such as, let's give it a padding bottom of 5 pixel and padding top of 5 pixel also. And now you will see it's looking beautiful. We have built a beautiful looking blog section. So the last part of the build is our footer section. So the footer section, we let's go to the index.html file and create a footer. So in the footer under the container, because we don't want a background color of gray right now, so footer, I will give it a class name of footer. Now we have a section, or we can say, so let's use a section. You can also use a div and give it a class name of footer dash container. So in this container, as you will see, we have a left part where we have a social container, two menu containers and a button. So first one will be a social dash container, and the second one will be a menu. Third one will also be a menu, and the fourth one will be a button, which will say request invite. So for social container, we have four social media icon. First one will be a Facebook, second one will be a Instagram, third one will be, I think so, it will be a Twitter, and the fourth one will be a, I think so, it will be a Pinterest. So for menu items, we have, let's see which are the items we have. We have about us, contact, blog. First one will be a, about us. The second one will be a contact us, and the third one will be a blog. So in the second menu container, we have three items: carriers, sport, privacy policy. So I will copy these three and change the text. So let's change. We have carriers, sport, and the third one will be a privacy policy. Let's save this. And I think so, let's go to our demo. Go to our website. Now you'll see it's not looking good. We just want to style our footer. Let's go target the footer, give it a background color of the same that we have used as the heading, which will be this blue color. Let's give it a height of 30, viewport height. Let's see how to look. Now you'll see we have a beautiful looking header background. We just want to, so let's target the footer dash container, and in which we will have a width of 80%, margin left will be auto, margin right will be auto, and the color will be a white. Let's save this, and now you will see we don't see our links. So first of all, use a flex box to align it in the horizontal direction. Display a flex. Justify content will be a not flex dot. It will be a space between, and align items will be flexed. Let's see. Now these have aligned in the horizontal direction. Target the menu, and in the menu we have a text. Set the text decoration to not white. Set it to none. Color will be a white. Let's save it. And now we can see the menu items. So for footer container, give it a padding top of, I think 2 RAM will look good. Yeah, the 2 RAM is enough. So what we'll do, we'll target the social container dot social dash container, give it a margin top of 3 RAM. 3 RAM is good. So we'll also target the button and the footer container. We have a button, give it a margin top of 3 RAM, and let's see. Now they have aligned in the same direction. And for the menu, we will use flexbox to align it in the column direction. We set the flex direction to column, justify content to space between, and align items to, oops, not align self, align items to flex dot. Let's see. Now you'll see it's looking good, but we just want to increase the margin bottom and set the margin bottom to 15 pixel, set the font weight to 600. So let's see. Now you see it's looking good. We just want to give a space to social container icon. Oops, give it a margin left of 10 pixel. Set the cursor to pointer. And now you'll see we have a space between our icons. Now it's looking beautiful. So for the button, we will use the same values or properties that we have used for our button in the hero section. Copy all of these. Go to our footer. So here is our button. Give it the same properties. And now you see we have a beautiful looking button. So the last part of our build is also completed. We just want to remove this white space, which is a margin bottom to our block. So here is our block. Just to remove the margin bottom, oops, not to heading, for our block here, just remove the margin button. We have give it a margin button for test purposes. So now you will see it's looking good. So we have built a beautiful looking website. So let's review what we have built. We have a beautiful looking navigation menu where we have a nav bar, call to action button, and an eye-catching design of a hero section. So the second part is YS section and then feature section, where we have an eye-catching and we are giving an amazing user experience to our users and clients. So the user interface is quite amazing. So we just want to change the content of our blog, so the heading and paragraph such as, and the image. So let's go to our index.html. So here we will remove, or we can replace the, so here is our article. First one will be the same. So for second one, I will copy the heading. So here will be heading. For second one will be, I think so, this one, treat yourself without worrying about money. Control C. So yeah, this one. Remove this heading, replace it, and then change the paragraph also. We will use this paragraph in place of this. So we also have to change the icon, which is the image. The third one will be a, I think so. So let's copy the class, not class name, heading. Control C. So this one will be for the third one. So for the fourth one, it will be a, so first of all copy the paragraph for the third blog article. So let's replace it with our paragraph, and for the fourth one we'll use this heading, which will say our invite only beta accounts are live now. Control C, Control V. So for paragraph it will be this one. So it's image. So let's change the images also. So for the fourth one, the image will be images, and here we'll use this image. So for the third one is, I think, want. So for the third one we have a image of plane. So let's replace this currency image with the image of plane. And the second one will be a, I think so, for second one we will have an image of, it will be a restaurant image. So let's replace the currency image for the second one to restaurant. Let's save this, and now you will see a beautiful looking article where we have different images. So this is the end of the tutorial, because we have built a beautiful looking eye-catching website design with just HTML and CSS. So if you haven't subscribed to this channel, I hope you will subscribe to this channel, because you will get a lot of value and knowledge from this channel, because I upload daily projects about front-end development by using HTML and CSS. I built projects of complete website designs from start to finish, and I will also upload projects about JavaScript, which will help you to improve your skills. And this is the end. So have a nice day, and let's see what's coming for the next project. Tell me pretty lies, look me in the face, tell me that you love me, even if it's fake.